Welcome to How to DJ with your DDJ-SB2. I'm your tutor, Joey Santos, and in this course, I'm going to show you how to mix with Pioneer DJ's DDJ-SB2 controller and the included Serato DJ Lite software. I'm sure you're just as excited as I am to get started, so let's kick things off with a brief overview. The DDJ-SB2 is a two-channel controller, and that means it can control up to two decks in Serato DJ Lite, which is the software that comes bundled with it. We're going to install that software in the next video. So there are a lot of buttons, knobs, and pads over here in this controller. I'm going to go through all of them, but first let's start here on the left side of the deck, starting from the top. This is the effects section. You've got three buttons here, which enable or disable the effects in Serato DJ Lite. And you've also got a knob, which lets you adjust the intensity of those effects. Over here on the left, you've got the tempo or the pitch fader, moving it up, slows down the track, moving it down, speeds it up. And over here, you've got a nice big jog wheel. This lets you shuttle forward or backwards in the track, and you can even grab it and do some scratches. The jog wheel is nice, has a great feel to it, and yes, you can use it for scratching and doing some cool routines. Over here, you've got the key lock button. When this is engaged, that means that if you slow down or speed up the track, the pitch of the tune doesn't change. Back in the good old days of using vinyl and turntables for DJing, if you slow down the turntable or you sped it up, the pitch of the song changed. Now with digital, we don't need to worry about that thanks to key lock. So you'll always want to make sure that key lock is engaged, and that's what we're going to be doing for the rest of this course. Now below the key lock, it's the deck select button. Yes, you can control up to two decks in Serato DJ because this is a two-channel controller. So that means that you control deck one and deck two in Serato DJ Lite. However, just by pressing the deck select button, you can access deck number three over here on the left, and conversely, you can select deck number four over here on the right. I'm going to explain more about advanced deck switching or accessing decks three and four later on in this course. Now, below that, you've got the vinyl mode button. When this is engaged, that means that if you grab the jog wheel and you move it forwards and backwards, you can do a scratching sound. And when this is disengaged, that means that moving the jog wheel forwards just speeds up the track. Of course, if you've got vinyl engaged and you want to do some scratching, you can still speed up or slow down a track just by moving the sides of the jog wheel. And this is handy for doing manual beat mixing, which we will cover later on in the course. Okay, so over here on the left, you've got the mic level knob. Because yes, the DDJ-SB2 has a microphone input. That means you can plug in a mic and you can be your own MC while you're DJing, and you can adjust the volume using the knob over here. Next, you've got the pad trance button. When this is engaged, it turns the four performance pads here into a pad transformer effect. I'm going to explain this later on in the course. Don't worry about that for now. Now over here at the very bottom, you've got your performance pad and transport controls. These are the four performance pads, and their functions depends on what pad mode you've got highlighted. If hot cue is enabled, that means that the four pads here are for triggering hot cues in Serato DJ Lite. If it's for auto loop, the four pads are for setting auto loops that are dependent on beat size or beat length. I'm going to explain that later on. Manual loop lets you add in and out points that aren't dependent on a specific length. Again, going to explain that later on. And the sampler mode turns these four pads into sampler triggers, because yes, Serato DJ Lite has a built-in sampler. That's going to be covered in the more advanced section of this course. Now, below the four performance pads, you've got the four transport controls over here. I'm going to go over them briefly. You've got the play pause button here for playing or pausing the track. You've got the cue button here, which lets you place a hot cue. And every time you press the cue button, Serato DJ Lite automatically jumps back to that cue point. Usually, you place it at the beginning of the track. Now you've got the sync button here, and what the sync button does is it automatically matches the tempo of the track that you are about to mix in. Now the shift button lets you access the secondary controls of some of the buttons over here. Well, we don't need to go through all of them right now, but just as an example, if you hold down the shift button and you press the key lock button, what you're doing is you are engaging the tempo range selector. So this allows you to change the pitch faders tempo range to a larger amount. We're not going to cover that in this course because it's a little bit more advanced, but basically that's what the shift button is for. Cool. So now that we're done with the left deck, let's have a look at the right. As you can see, it is basically a mirror image of the left deck, and you're going to find like all the buttons to be the same. I just want to point out that the deck select button here accesses deck number 4 because this is deck number 2 in Serato DJ Lite. So pressing the deck select button accesses deck number 4. All right. Cool. So that's it for the left and the right. Now let's move on over to the center of the unit. Over here at the top, you've got the two load buttons and a browse knob. Basically, what the browse knob does is it lets you go through your playlists or crates in Serato DJ Lite as well as your tracks. I'm going to explain how this works later on. And the load buttons lets you load those tracks over onto the left deck by pressing the left button, or the right deck by pressing the right button. This is cool, so you don't have to reach for your laptop and, you know, take your hands off your controller if you just want to load a deck. You've got the controls for that over here on the face of the unit. Now, below that, you've got the master level knob, which lets you adjust how loud the volume is going out of the main speakers. And over here, you've got the headphone mix. And the headphone mix lets you hear a blend of what's coming through the headphones. If you move it fully anti-clockwise, you're just going to hear what's coming out of the headphone cue mix. Basically, that means that if you are queuing up the next song, let's say you're trying to look for another track to play and you want to hear how it sounds like, so you want to preview it, you want to drop like a hot cue or something like that, you move the headphone mix knob and then you press the cue button over here, depending on which deck you'd want to hear in the headphones. I'm going to explain this later on. Now, if you move this fully clockwise, that means it's going to be set to master and you are only going to be hearing what's coming out of the speakers, and you're going to hear that in your headphones. Usually while you're mixing, you're going to want to set this somewhere in the middle, so you hear a mix of both what's coming out of the speakers and also what's in the headphone cue. Again, I'm going to explain this later on, so don't worry about that just yet. Below that, you've got the headphones level knob, so this dictates, or this lets you adjust the volume of your headphones. Don't set it all the way clockwise because that's gonna ruin your hearing. Just be careful and, you know, set a nice, decent level. Just enough so you hear what you're queuing up next or what's playing. Right? And let's move over here on these three knobs, or these four knobs rather. This is the trim pot. This is for the left deck. This one's for the right deck. Trim pot lets you adjust the gain of a track. So sometimes there are some tracks that are louder than others. You can use this to fine-tune that gain. And then below that, you've got a three-band EQ, high, mids, and low. The highs lets you adjust the treble. The mids lets you adjust the mid-range. This is usually where you'd find vocals, snare drums, synthesizers, and all that stuff. So if you move this fully anti-clockwise, you're gonna find like a little bit of a dip in the musical range. So usually you just keep that as is. And below the mids, you've got the lows. This lets you cut out the bass just by moving it fully anti-clockwise, or it lets you boost the bass a little bit. So this is essential when we're gonna be doing mixing, just because it helps you achieve a smoother mix so it doesn't sound too woolly or thumpy. I'm gonna explain that later. Below the EQ section, you've got a filter knob. Moving it clockwise lets you filter out the low frequencies. Again, this is useful for mixing. And moving it anti-clockwise lets you filter out the high frequencies. So this gives you a duller sound because all of the high-end sizzle is being filtered out of the track. Okay, cool. Now, over here, you've got two cue buttons. These are the headphone cues. Remember earlier, I was saying that if you move this knob all the way anti-clockwise, all you're gonna hear is the deck that you've got queued up. So pressing a cue button will enable a track to be sent to your headphones as a headphone cue. So that lets you preview a track. Let's say you're deciding what track to play next and you want to hear it first in your headphones so the audience doesn't hear it coming out of the speakers. You press the cue button there and then you make the necessary adjustments or the song choice. Cool. Now below the headphone cues, you've got the channel level. This is a 6-segment LED meter, shows you how loud your track is. If it's always in the red, that's not a good thing, so you need to turn the volume down. And what you usually do is you can use the trim pots in order to just make it a little bit lower. So we're gonna see that in action later on. Now on opposite sides of the level meter, you've got two volume faders. This basically lets you fade a track out or fade it in. And over here, we've got the filter fade button. When this is set to on, what this does is it applies an automatic filter to the crossfader. And the crossfader is here at the very bottom of the controller, and it lets you fade from one deck to another. So, for example, let's say I've got a track playing over here in the left deck, and I want to mix in a track over here on my right deck. So while this is playing, I'm gonna cue up a track here. And then let's say I'm gonna press play. And what I do is I move the crossfader from the left over onto the right. So all that we're gonna be hearing now is the track on the right deck. And now what the filter fade does is it automatically applies a filter to remove the low frequencies. Why would you wanna do that? If you've got two tracks with a lot of low end or a lot of bass playing at the same time, sometimes it could overload the speakers. It just makes it sound too woolly, too thick, and that's what a filter is useful for. So that's it for the overview of the DDJ-SB2. So I just gave you a brief overview of the DDJ-SB2. If you haven't already, have a play with the controls, have a spin on the jog wheels, and get used to the feel of the unit. It's designed to be durable as DJs tend to work their gear really hard. Basically, get comfortable with where everything is. In the next lesson, we're gonna download and install the Serato DJ Lite software on your computer. I'll see you then.